believe it or not, this thing is actually stationary. It's not moving.
The soil was eroded away. We missed the crops entirely.
This year in the United States alone, there have been 19 billion dollar plus severe weather events. Climate change is really the driver behind the massive financial increase of the impacts.
We need higher resolution. We need more observations. Underlying all that is the need for more computational horsepower.
Now, whenever we have computer models that we look at, it may be on a massive grid, 12 kilometers. You have these huge spaces between data points that you're not getting any information on. But with GRAF, you're taking that down to 3 kilometers. So you're not missing the giant thunderstorms that might be forming underneath here. You're not missing the formation point of the hurricane that might be developing under there or the typhoon. You're getting this more closely knit look at what our atmosphere is doing and what it might do in the future.
In order to do that, you have to know what's happening everywhere in the atmosphere right now. Supercomputing and AI have had a profound impact on our ability to map the atmosphere and predict the future.
Being on IBM Cloud enables us to scale very quickly. It's reliable, it's resilient.
We can leverage a combination of different observations. Observations from the ground, observations in the air from aircraft, and satellite observations. GRAF is going to bring new capabilities to forecasting that we haven't seen before.
Companies' operations can be really impacted. Do they have enough materials for their customers and for their operations? Do they have crews out working that they need to keep safe? We have clients in aviation. Do they need to delay flights? Do they need to reroute flights to other areas?
If we know we're going to be landing during thunderstorms in Beijing, we can provide a smoother ride for our customers.
We're really targeting regions across the globe that traditionally we've spent less time focused on. So places like Delhi, India, for instance, Mexico City, places like South America and Brazil.
And so the farmer in Kenya will have just as great of a forecast as the farmer in Kansas.
How do we democratize weather? How do we bring good weather forecasts to people throughout the world?
Getting the right information in the hands of the people is the first step.